Adobe's been here for more than a decade now, mm-hmm. and we've been serving the creative community all the while, mm-hmm. and slowly we've nurtured this community. But while we've done that now, I think our objective now is continue to keep owning this creative community and grow it by larger amount this time. So same objective, but the momentum has to be higher now. Mm-hmm. We need to achieve more in a smaller amount of time. Okay. That's the key objective. So continue to serve the creative community and grow it even faster now as we move forward into FY12 and beyond. And we're taking a couple of initiatives around how we... So we own a healthy market share in terms of managing this creative community, but the intent is to increase it further. Traditionally, we've been very good on the print side, on the website, and then the video side, right? So we do all three, print, web, and video. Mm-hmm. And we're also good at moving all this content across devices, mm-hmm. across multi-screens. So whether it is a desktop or a laptop, mm-hmm. or whether it is a content on the paper, or whether it is content which is moving from these two into the mobile devices, we are good at all three. So we cover all three ranges here. That's something unique about Adobe. Mm-hmm. Whatever solutions that we are creating, we can move them to a device of any form factor.
Okay.
And we don't need to do a design again. Mm-hmm. The same design, we are capable of moving that onto any form factor. So it doesn't matter what's the length or breadth of the device, we can move the content. And it'll give you a same customer experience that you get on your laptop or any other device that you are used to. Wide range of customer base, Aida, starting from prosumers, which are professional consumers of our technology, and we move on to the mid-market, and then to wide range of users, and we start from prosumers, and these guys professionally depend on our technology to create business for them. So we start from them. They are most avid users of Adobe. They swear by us, and from there on we move on to the small and medium business, where a whole lot of creative community depends on Adobe, whether it is the print or web. Now we've taken another dimension in India, whereas we are wanting to serve the enterprises as well. So we've added a complete line of business around selling to the enterprises. So we cover the entire gamut, starting from prosumers to the mid-market to the enterprise. Always serve the entire market. However, we are more focused on the enterprise also now. When we say enterprise, we're talking about IT, ITS vertical, BFSI, the large government initiatives that are taking place in the country, hospitality and BFSI is already said. So all these segments is what our focus is going to be on. There is a rampant use of software which is not legally procured in the country. So mm-hmm. I think there are a couple of actions that we draw from them. One is to really increase the awareness around the proper use of the Adobe software, which is the first initiative that we are taking. Mm-hmm. Second is to make our software available widely. It has to be closer to the end user who wants to buy the software. So it's easier for him rather than to scout out for not genuine used copy. That's the second. And third, I think beyond these two, more kind of coming closer to the consumer kind of objectives, we're also trying to see that how we can kind of talk to people who are not really using the proper copy and make sure that we make them aware of what are the kind of advantages of using the proper copy. So we are taking that one-to-one dialogue with a lot of our end customers as well. So we are working around it in terms of improving the adoption of the genuine software. So they do. I think channel partners is a community which extends our reach. We as an organization are not big enough to serve the entire nooks and corners of the country, so we need extended arms, and channel acts as an extended arm for us. So the larger the community, the closer are we to them, so to the end customers. Mm-hmm. So that's the role that channel plays for us. So it's important that they become a part of evangelizing the Adobe software and taking it to the end user. All right, so I think that's an interesting question that you asked me, Saida, and it's at the right time also. There've been a set of partners who've been associated with us for a long time, and they've enjoyed margins which are something which comes with the product, right? So they sell it and then they enjoy some margin on that. There are backends also which are available. So for a particular behavior that they drive with us, there is a certain back end which is reserved for them. But at this point of time, when we are wanting to increase our reach inside the country, we are announcing a new partner program which is called Adobe Partner Connection. Mm-hmm. This is launching very soon, and we'll want to share more details about this program very soon with you. This program is redefining the way that partners can make money with us.
Okay.
So we are changing the quantum of money that they can make with us. The entire focus is on profitable growth. When I say profitable growth, we want these partners to grow, but in a manner which is profitable. Okay. So what I mean to say is, if a partner is spending some resources on Adobe, then we want him to earn more. And if that happens, I expect that partner to focus more on Adobe. And if he does that, then it's a win-win for both. The partner gets more earnings and I got a better top line. So that's what I'm aiming at. And the APC is my vehicle towards getting. So we are currently in our quarter one.
Okay.
We're getting off to quarter two with this new. My financial year starts from December. So December to November. So basically Q2 starts in. All across, Saida, as I was talking to you, we are relevant across the user segment. So, and if you look at the partner ecosystem that we have in country, it's a large partner ecosystem, 24,000 partners spread across the country. However, there are only a select group of partners who team up with us. So we'll have some partners who are focusing towards the tier 2, tier 3 cities, towards the prosumers. We'll have some partners who focus towards the mid-market. You know, we're also having a relationship with the system integrators who will help us kind of sell into the enterprises and build value for Adobe solutions in that environment. So across all segments and across verticals. So that's the relevance of an Adobe software. All Adobe users are avid fans of our software, and they exist across segments and across verticals. It's a software which is relevant to an end user, to a prosumer, as I was talking about. However, LFRs currently are catering to specific softwares, and we'd also be present there in some time.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that the per unit cost of our software is higher than any other software, so that seems to be a little bit of a deterrent. But LFRs is a medium for us.
Mm-hmm.
It's a medium for us. And Adobe sold software across the world through LFRs. We've not started this journey in India, but we've seen real successes across the globe on LFRs.